We're going to look at our heart rate one more time, this time using light as a sensor. You can see that there's a LED that acts as the light probe in this device, and on the other side of it is the photodiode that's the sensor to see what is transmitted. In our lab, we're going to use this photodiode, and you can see that the body of it is clear. The sensor is actually on the top face, and so when you put it in your circuit, you could do something like I did. I wrapped a black wire around the periphery to make sure that it was really getting light from the top. We're going to put our finger on the top of that. In terms of our ISOM idea, we're using this photodiode as the sensor. This is the circuit symbol. And our measurement is going to be voltage versus time. And what we're trying to do is isolate the pulse of your heart that is coming through on the photodiode. As your blood is pumped through, it changes the absorption in your finger. So there'll be a sensor portion of the circuit, and that will be followed by a filter, which is followed by an amplifier, and then another filter and another amplifier. So the challenge in the design of this circuit is designing this filtering and amplifying portion of the circuit, of the instrumentation. And the amplifier we're using is one that you've seen before. It's an active amplifier. It requires an op amp, and the op amp is wired in negative feedback with the input being from the sensor or the filtering stage, and the output being tied to the negative terminal. This should be just a wire here. So your trick in this design of the instrumentation is choosing the R1 and R2 values so that the amplification is the right size, and also it's inside the op amp's operating range. Can't output more than something like a milliamp. When you first hook up the sensor circuit, you might get some pretty wild results, and this is because the photodiode is very sensitive, so any movement in your finger is going to be amplified, and so you'll have to just sit still, and as you can see, the pulse starts to show up if you sit with stillness with your finger on the photodiode. Now, again, you don't want to press too hard on the photodiode, because if you do, it will actually prevent the light from coming through. So you want to set your finger very gently on that photodiode, and just kind of take your time and allow the circuit to do its work. Okay, let's look at the sensor detail. The sensor itself is going to be hooked up to an op amp to give us a little bit of filtering and amplification. So we're going to treat this whole, circuit block as the sensor. And that output will go to the filtering portion of the circuit. Now, when you get done with your circuit, to see how it performs, we're going to essentially, for the Bode plot, we will decouple the sensor from the circuit and use the filter input as the Bode input. And this whole circuit has a magnification or amplification of about 100x. So remember, our oscope is limited in its own output to, 5 volts. So our input, we want to be probably on the order of, 10 millivolts in order for it to give you the full performance of the circuit in the Bode plot. And in terms of the frequency, sort of the lowest frequency we choose should be something below the heart rate, so we can see how it treats these low frequencies below the heartbeat rate.